Hi and welcome to another one of the performance reviews by the Tech Geeks. My name is Paul. Today we're going to be answering a question which is what speed can I get from my UDM Pros? In 2025, September here in Australia, NBN, if you had fiber to the property, was upgraded, or many customers were offered a 2 gigabit a second connection. So we started to get a lot of questions about what performance can I get from my UDM Pros? What happens if I turn on intrusion prevention and content filtering? Do I see a performance decrease? I'm just going to concentrate on the UDM Pros here. We have done some videos for performance on the UCG Fiber and the UCG Max, which you can find over on our YouTube channel. So let's hop on over here to what we've got on the bench. So I've got three here. So at the top, the UDM Pro is the original one that was that came out. So what do we have? We have 8 ports of non-PoE here. We have a 1 gig Ethernet WAN port, and we have 2 10 gig SFP plus transceiver ports. Then we have the UDM-SE, slightly upgraded, mainly around the PoE. So we've got 8 ports of PoE, well, 6 ports of PoE, 2 ports of PoE plus. We had an upgraded 2.5 gigabit a second WAN connection, and then 2 10 gig SFP plus ports. And then we had the UDM Pro Max, which is a bit of a combination of both. We had 2 hard drive bays so we could have fault tolerance. It could handle more devices. It had no PoE and it's 8 ports here. We had a 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port for the WAN, and again, 2 10 gig SFP plus ports. So how are we going to test this? We've got a 10 gigabit a second iPerf test server internally, so we don't need to do this over the internet to get our speed test. On this first device here, we're not going to test what we're going to get on the 1 gig port because we know it's going to do 1 gig. What we're going to do is we're going to plug in our 10 gig SFP plus here to give us 10 gig out to our for our WAN, for our test internet connection. And then we're going to use a multi-gig transceiver. This is the RJ45MG. This one's going to go in. What's this allows us to do? Well, this allows us to take to Ethernet in a 1 gig, 2.5, 5 gig, and 10 gig Ethernet port. And we're going to then plug that in, and we're going to have our 10 gig a second test server, Windows server on the LAN side of this. And we're going to be able to test that performance throughput. We're then going to repeat back here on the UDM Pro SE. We will do a test on the 2.5 gigabit a second to see what speed we can get. And then again, using 10 gig for those two interfaces, WAN and LAN. And again, finally on the UDM Pro Max, we're going to test on our 2.5 gigabit and our 2 10 gig SFP plus ports. And that's going to show us what we're going to be able to maximize get on here. We're going to test each one of those with IPS turned on and off, and content filtering on and off as well, so you can see if there's a degradation in speed across them all. So let's just jump on to the computer and let's get some tests running. Okay, so we're just here in the standard settings of our UDM Pro. We're gonna do a first test here with all the intrusion prevention and content filtering turned off. So you can see on here, intrusion prevention is off. In content filtering, we've not declared a policy yet. So as a result, it's not on. Now, obviously, it will depend on the version of the operating system you got into, what this looks like in Unified Network for you, but it'll be roughly the same. So what we're just going to do, head on over to our little test machine. Like I said, it's got a 10 gig interface. So we've got 10 gig on the WAN, 10 gig on the LAN. We're going to have a little test to see what we can get as a result. So we're just going to be using iPerf. We've got a 10 gig test server at the other side. This computer is on the LAN side of our UDM Pro. And we're just going to send a number of streams. We're trying to work out what is the best number of streams. I'm going to try and send 10 to this at the moment, get ourselves an idea. So here we go. Without any of those content filtering or intrusion prevention running, you can see that we're getting there 6.4 gigabits a second of throughput. Now, I'm not sure how much we're going to see as a difference if we now head on over and turn our intrusion prevention on. So let's just turn that on. Putting it on the default network, which by default is the LAN side of this. I want to notify and block just to add some features in there. Just going to quickly scan through. What do we got? Turn on all the options in here. And so we're scanning for everything that we can scan for and apply the settings. Also just want to add on content filtering at the same time. We'll add on safe search. Now, none of this should actually make any impact for us right now. Hang on, just select the network again once on our basic LAN network, because we're not actually doing any web surfing as part of this test, but I just want to see if the engine slows down because it's actually having to look inside the packets and do something with it. So with those turned on, we'll maybe give it a few moments just to settle and implement them. Let's just do a retest of this with 10 streams. So you can see a significant drop off there. It fluctuates is what I would expect with intrusion prevention because it needs to identify the packet and then decide whether that packet is going to run through or not. Remember, we were getting 6.4 before. We're getting 6.3, 6.2, sometimes a 6.4. So I think maybe the overheads here maybe would be safe to say you're losing maybe 200 megabits a second. But as you can see, that's really not for much on the throughput of the device, especially if you're trying to put this on a 2 gig connection. You're going to be amply managing to make that work. So let's now go on and do this again with the next one, the UDM-SE. Okay, so here we are on the UDM-SE. Now we're going to test this on the 2.5 gigabit a second WAN port. So obviously we're not going to get more than 2.5 gigabits a second. So we're going to try that first. And then we'll turn on intrusion prevention, and then we'll swap that over to use the 10 gig just again to see the overall performance. So we've got no intrusion prevention running, and we don't have a content filtering policy. So let's head on over to our test machine again. Let's run our iPerf test, and you can see 2.4, 2.3 gigabits a second on a 2.5 gigabit port, which is what we would expect. There's some overheads in there that will take that down. So let's now go over and do exactly the same as we did previously. So we're just going to add this in as a test policy. We are going to choose our network here. Again, the content filtering really shouldn't make much difference. I just want to have that engine running. So we really want to be turning on our intrusion prevention. So we want notify and block, make sure all of these have been moved to the maximum that they can be for inspection of vulnerabilities. And then again, we're just going to push our throughput, give that a moment or so. So let's head on back to our test now. Again, are we expecting to see this drop off a little bit? Maybe, maybe not. We're only running at 2.5 gigabits a second, which should be less than the device is capable of. Are we averaging a little bit lower? Maybe not a lot. You can see 2.45, 2.37. So I would say on here, this is really not performing anything less than what I would expect on its 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port, which is good. We're seeing no difference really. Maybe 50 or 60 megabits a second, as you can see there, as the IPS engine kicks in, but nothing really significant. So let's swap that over to the 10 gig interface and repeat the process. Okay, so I switched over the cables. We're now running on the 10 gig WAN connection and 10 gig LAN. I've turned off intrusion prevention. I've removed the content filtering policy. So let's just head on over into the computer here, have a quick speed test of what we're seeing with 10 streams. We're seeing there 6.5, so this is maybe just very slightly faster than the UDM Pro, not a lot really in it. But again, this is a set, so we know where to go from here. So now let's just head back on over in and turn on, or we're gonna create a quick policy on here. Select this to be default and add this in. And then we're going to turn on our intrusion prevention just like we did before. So again, making sure that all the policies are turned on. We want this to notify and block. All right, so all of those are set as we want it to be. We're just wanting to, again, like I said, all repeating the same thing, just proving that with the engine running, it is not reducing the overall speed of this device. So let's now again do our test. Let's try and see what we're going. So we're seeing a little bit less. This maybe shows a little bit more on this device, maybe because it's got a little bit more power. And again, I don't think it's really much dissimilar to the UDM Pro. We're maybe seeing 150 to 200 megabits a second of drop off of speed. That's probably about it. And obviously, again, like some of that is just the way that intrusion prevention is running. But again, a really good performance, and it's going to be fine on a 2 gig internet connection. So let's head on now, and we'll do that on the UDM Pro Max and see if we've got any performance differences on that one. Okay, so I've moved on over to the UDM Pro Max. Again, we're starting this with the 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port out to the WAN. So we're not going to get faster than that in our initial speed test. As you can see here, we've got no intrusion prevention running, no content filtering. So let's just run over to our speed test here. And let's just fire that up and see the result that we are going to get. So again, we're hitting that expected 2.3 to 2.5. We're not expecting to see anything different because we are on a 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port. So let's just head on over back in now to our settings. Let's get our intrusion prevention turned on, notify and block. Obviously run through all of these, make sure that we're testing everything just to get the best performance review that we can on this. So those are all applied now. And we're just gonna create that basic content filtering test rule with safe search on. I don't know whether I remember putting that on. I think I did put it on there for most of those. Again, it's just to get this engine going. Just to see if there is any performance difference to it. So those are all on now. Probably will take a couple of moments. So let's just try our speed test a couple of times and see what happens. I'm really not expecting anything on this 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port to have any performance drop. I think the engine on its own should be well fast enough for that. As you can see, again, there's nothing really happening there that makes that think that we're losing any speed. We'll just give it one more test just to be sure if I'm probably maybe get the results right. There we go, let's have a little look. So again, we're sitting at 2.3. It does jump up sometimes to around about 2.5, which obviously is the maximum we can see on this port anyway. So let me just go and change over the cable so we can run on the 10 gig and give it a go there. Okay, so that 10 gig Ethernet port is active. What we're just gonna quickly do is remove these test ones that we had in place, turn off intrusion prevention. So that we can get this back to our standard running state. So that should be now being able to give us a test on our 10 gig. So let's run this up and see what we can get. Again, we're seeing pretty much the same as we have seen across all of the units. Maybe again, slightly, just a little tweak faster, 6.78. So it's maybe another 200 megabits a second faster than we've seen on the previous model that we tested, the UDM-SE. And that was just maybe 100 faster than the other one. So let's now just flick back over, go and turn our intrusion prevention on, make sure all of our options are set as we've done on all of the others here and here. Let's just apply that. We're just gonna make sure our content filtering engine is set and running. Again, not really a massive drain as I've kept saying on this one, but it's good to just see this in place. So that's set in there again. And so now we should just be able to flick back, just check that I had turned intrusion prevention on. There we go. So let's just flick back onto here. And let's have a look at our speed again, 6.2, 6.51, 6.53, 6.49, 6.5. So this is probably a little bit more consistent with what we actually saw with the one without any of the content filtering or intrusion prevention running. And it seems to be holding its speed a little bit closer, but again, a really, really good speed result even with intrusion prevention and content filtering running, and obviously again on a great on a 2 gig or above connection. So hopefully that's been useful to actually see the performance that we can get through these three UDM Pros. As you can see, with intrusion prevention turned on and content filtering running, we were still getting around about 4 to 5 gigabits a second. Maybe we were losing 150 to 200 megabits a second when the services were turned on, but plenty for an NBN or internet connection of 2 gig or above. Hopefully that's been useful. Why don't you head on over to our YouTube channel? We've got plenty more reviews, how-to guides, performance reviews, setups, rough and readies. So why don't you head there, subscribe, and stay up to date.